see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright, blessed day.
When a child is raped, is God responsible and did he decree that rape?
If he didn't, then that rape is an element of meaningless evil that has no purpose. What I'm trying to point out by going to Scripture...
So what is your answer there? Because I want to understand the answer to that question.
I'm trying to go to Scripture to answer.
Yes, but what is the answer to the question that he just asked so that we can understand what the answer is?
I mentioned to him, yes, because if not, then it's meaningless and purposeless. And though God knew it was going to happen... He created without a purpose. That means God brought the evil into existence, knowing it was going to exist, but for no purpose, no redemption, nothing positive, nothing good.
So he did decree it, and if he decreed it, then there's meaning to it.
It has meaning, it has purpose. Suffering, all suffering has purpose. Everything in this world has purpose. There is no basis for despair. But if we believe that God created, knowing all this was going to happen, but with no decree, he just created, and all this evil's out there, and there's no purpose, then every rape, every situation like that is nothing but purposeless evil, and God is responsible for the creation of despair. And
For years I've been trying to figure out why it is that in order for rape to exist, or unless God caused it to happen, there can't be any purpose in it. God can use evil, and he does. But to blame God, which is what a decree does, to blame God for the rape of a child is a horrible attack on the very character and the love of God.